this video we're going to cover the processing of n jobs through the two machines. Let the two machines are A and B. The simple possible sequencing problem is that n jobs, that is on two machines sequencing problem. So this is one of the simplest problem that you are going to handle. Next time we're going to handle n job in the three machines. We want to determine the sequence in which the n job should be processed through the two machines only in a prescribed order so as to minimize the total elapsed time. So our idea is to get the lowest possible time to complete the job. And we have the following assumption like this. Only two machines A and B are involved. Each job is processed in the fixed order, that is A and A and B. Means the job is performed on A and in the same order it is performed on B. The actual or expected processing time of each job in both machines are known to us. So previously our knowing that what are the timing we required, that is the turning we required, grinding we required. So we can calculate that time and that is always fixed for both the products. So the simplest algorithm is given by Johnson for n job on two machines. And the algorithm says that you first find out the shortest processing time. Shortest processing time among the job. Whatever the jobs list is given to you, first of all you find out the shortest processing time. If the two or more jobs are tied, choose one job arbitrarily. So first select that job which has the shortest possible time. Step number two, if the shortest processing time is on the workstation one, and schedule the corresponding as early as possible. And if the shortest processing time is on the workstation two, schedule the corresponding job as late as possible. Let's say we have machine one data for us, and let's say we have machine data two. And let's say the job order is 8, 3, 9, 4, and 5. So in this one the smallest time is 2. So first of all you assign this side is from 1 and this side is for machine 2. So minimum time is belongs to 1. So assign first job C here. If you have done this, cancel this. Now check which is the lowest time. The lowest time is now 3. So you select 3 now. So C is for machine B. But either the machine is to be lowest for machine 2. So you start entering from this side. So this will be B. So now you cancel this one. You left with 5, 7, 8, 4 and 5 and 8. So minimum time is 4. This one is for machine D. And machine D and the lowest is on 2. So you have to enter from this side. That will be D. So cancel now D column. Now we are 8 and 5, 5 and 8. So minimum time is 5 and 5. So as per alphabetical, we'll put A here and then we'll put E here. So we have one option is this and second option is C, E, A, D, B also. So both options will give you same time and the performance parameters is also be same. This is a question appeared in GATE 2006. A manufacturing shop processed sheet metal job wherein each job must pass through machine M1 and M2. And in the order processing time in hours for this job is given, you want to find out optimal make span time in the hours. So we are given here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 jobs and we are given machine 1 and machine 2. So first of all you have to apply the Johnson rule. According to Johnson rule, you have to first find out what is the lowest processing time in this one and according to that you have to fit from. So first of all see the lowest time in the machine M1. So the lowest time here is 8, lowest time is here is 6. 6 entry will be for machine 2. So first of all we'll perform P. So cancel this column now. Now you're left with this one. So the lowest time in this one is 7. So 7 is job U on machine M2. So this one is U. Now cancel this. Now the out of this the lowest time is 8. So select 8. 8 is job R. So that is the first number. Cancel this one. Now 32, 27, 11 and 19, 20, 14. So the lowest. So cancel this. Now we are left with 32. 27, 19 and 20. So 19 is lowest. So that is for machine 2. So this one is Q. And finally we left with the job S. So this one is job S. So optimum sequence is R, T, S, Q, P by Johnson's rule. Now once you have prepared the sequence, you have to make one more table for make span. So make the table. This side is for M1 machine and this side is M2 machine. Because first job is performed on M1 and then job is performed on M2. The sequence you have to make as per Johnson rule, that is R, T, S, Q, U, P. In this column you have to write down processing time on machine 1 for job R1, for R job the machine in time is 8 and 13 on machine B. For job T, machine time is 11 and 14. For job S, 27 and 20. For job Q, 32 and 19. For job U, timing is 16 and 7. For job P, 15 and 6. Now one more column I will make here, that is the ideal time for machine 2. Now I will start with the first job. So first job will be start on 08 day and will finish up on 8 day. After 8 day we can start the next job, that is D job. It take 11 day, so it will finish up by 19 day. On 19 day we can start the next. So on 19 we can start the next job. 19 plus 27 is 36 and 46. So on 46 we can start the next job. 46 plus 32 will be 78. 78 we can start the next job is 94 plus 94 is 109 days. So we can finish up by 109 day. Now we'll start with the second job. The job is ready after 8. So it will in the next, this job will machine. The same job R after perform on machine 1 now goes to machine 2 after completing the processing time on machine 1, that is 8 days. So it will be 8 days in. 8 plus 13, 13 will be 21. So this will be finished up by 21. So idle time for this one will be 0 first. Now machine will be free on 21 day, whereas the job is ready on 19. So machine can take the job as soon as it become free, that is on 21 day. So job is remain idle for 2 days. So it's a 21 day. So 21 day it will start the job T on machine 2. So 24 plus 21 plus 14 is 35. So idle time for the machine is 0, but idle time is the for the job here only. So after 35 the machine can start on 35, but the job is not ready because the job is ready on 46 day. It means that you have to keep the machine idle for 11 hours, and therefore we can start for after 46 hours. Job will take 20 days, so 46 plus this is 66. Now job, the machine is ready after 66, but the job is not ready till by 78. So the machine will be idle because of this 78 period. So 78 minus will be idle for 12 hours. After 12 hours means 78, it can accept the new job. Plus 19 will complete that job, will be 87 and will be 97. Now the machine is available only after 97, the job is already ready. But we cannot take the job because machine is free by 97 hours. So we can take the job on 97. So machine is not idle now. 97 plus 7 is 104. Now the job is not ready till 109 days. Means you have to keep the machine idle for 5 days. So 104 plus 6. So 104 we can take, 109 we can take the job because job we are getting on 109 plus 6 is 115. In that case the machine is idle for 5 days. So machine 2 is idle for 11 plus 12 plus 5, that equals to this one is 3 and this one is 8, is 28 days. Whereas the machine 1 is idle, completed job after 109, but the total sequence of job is finished on 115. It means that the machine A or 1 is idle because we cannot start the next batch. So we have 115 minus 109, that equals to 6 hours. Whereas in the numerical it is asked to find out the optimal make span time. So whatever the time we are getting here is called as optimal make span time. So our answer is optimal make span time is equals to 115 hours. Sometimes they will ask you what is the idle time on machine 2 and idle time on machine 1. So you can calculate the idle time here on machine 2. Whereas to calculate the idle time for machine 1, check the maximum value on machine 2 and the maximum value of machine 1. The difference between these two is idle time for machine 1.